To be talking about upgrading your Wi-Fi mini PCI Express card inside your laptop. Many reasons why people are upgrading their Wi-Fi cards at the moment, partly because of 5 gigahertz is out, has been for some time, but the likes of BT particularly have introduced the home hub 4 and 5, which is 5 gigahertz. So obviously by upgrading to the new band, you've got less people using it, therefore less interference, which means more speed basically. Particularly useful if you live in a flat like myself, where you've got loads of people using the 2.4 gigahertz, it gets rather congested. But anyway, so let's talk about why I've thrown this video up here. Basically, I wish there was something like it when I was scouring the net. Basically, I installed a Intel 5300, sorry, a 5100 to begin with. It didn't work. I couldn't get the radio signal to work. So I then ordered the 5300, and I was surprised to find exactly the same problem. Now, the reason this is happening is because basically older laptops, they have the Wi-Fi on button. Now, it's either a switch, which you press, which has got the Wi-Fi signal, and you press it on your keyboard or on the top above the keyboard, or a flick switch on the side of the laptop. My laptop, which is the Toshiba, I actually enable it by pressing the FN and the F8 button. Now, the problem is the newer laptops don't have these switches. It's actually controlled by the software. Basically, the drivers, as far as I've led to believe, don't know how to use the on switch. And the other problem is the manufacturers, like in this case Toshiba, and I've heard IBM, Dell, HP, IBM, they have a whitelist within the BIOS, which basically says this card has an on and off switch, etc. However, this is it uses pin 20, which I'll talk about later on, which basically controls the on and off. I don't know the ins and out of it, but basically I'll try my best, and by the end of this video I'll be getting your card working for you if it is related to the radio pin 20 problem. So that's it for now. Let's move on. Now, I haven't searched the entire net for every card supported. It should be quite obvious. If you can't turn the radio on and the drivers are installing, then the particular problem, and it is an older laptop and you do have a switch on your laptop to turn the wireless on, then it's most likely the pin 20 problem. Now, for the cards which have been reported to work, I know, which is the Intel 4965, the Intel 5000 series, there's quite a few of them, which is the Intel 5100, the Intel 5300, the Intel 5300, and many more. I'm not going to compile a complete list. I'll let you make your own decision if you think it is the problem. There are reported various brands which are doing this, which is IBM, Dell, HP, Toshiba, just to mention some of the major manufacturers. I'm sure there's more. But let's move on. Now, finding pin 20 can be a bit weird. I would thought they would have gone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the top of the card, and then carried on underneath. This is not the case. Basically, the top side's all the odd numbers, so it goes 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. And on the back, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Reason being is it's actually, you're supposed to count the pin on one on the top and pin two on the bottom. So it goes one on the top, two on the bottom, three on the above, four on the bottom. Basically, I've included a diagram here, which basically tells you what the pins do. I don't particularly know. I'm not a guru on this front, but I can see pin 20 here is reserved, which means I assume that manufacturers can actually tap into that pin to do all types of stuff. In this case, it's the radio Wi-Fi switch. Now, we won't be working on the top, I've actually made the bottom in green. That's the size you want. Now, your card may be a longer PCIe card. This is a mini shorter card. However, I do believe that it will work on the longer card. So, give that a try. What I will say as well, which I haven't actually done a slide for, in this particular video, this particular card, which is the Wi-Fi Link 5300, you'll see it's got three antennas, so one, three, and two. Now, the particular laptop I installed this card into only had two antennas. So what I did is I ordered off eBay, I think I only paid like £1.50, and it came from China, is an antenna for a laptop. And basically the way I wired it up is I linked it, I connected it to the antenna 3, which is the grey triangle, and I actually wired it through, and I found there was extra space underneath the hard drive. Now, it's not particularly the best place, because the way antennas work is if you've got a lot of metal going on around it, it can interfere. But I've put it there, and I found it works great, so I'm not going to be moving that for the sake of it. I get 5 bars in all of my rooms, which I'm really happy with. But if you do find that you are having signal problems, make sure you have got the third antenna, and make sure you've put it in a spot where you'll get the least interference. Now, I do advise, when you do buy the antennas, make sure it's got a sealant around it. And what I mean by that, mine's got like a plastic cover. Because some of the antennas you can buy, they don't have that cover. So obviously, if it is metal, you'll have less places to put it, because you run the risk of shorting the PCB board inside your laptop. So bear that in mind. Try and get one which has got a sealant, and that way you can put it anywhere in the laptop. Let's move on. So I've just made this slide basically to show you the pins once again. So as you can see on the top side, it's all odds. So we've got the pin 1, which is even labelled on the PCB, to be honest. You might have a board which doesn't have that, but just for this video, I haven't done that. I have done that for you. So pin 1 at the start, pin 51 at the end on the front, and obviously the evens on the back. So here's the back of the card, and basically you got pin 52 on the left, pin 2 on the right, because we're looking at it as on the other side on the front, so you've got to think about the front when working out the pins. But the pin 20 is what I've marked out. Now, the way to cover this, now I've looked on the net, and it seems to be a lot of people are using just ordinary sellotape. You can use that. I don't advise it. There is a reason why people use electrical tape. That's because it has a higher melt point. So if you're using ordinary tape, and for whatever reason the card gets extremely hot, then I imagine the glue would be the first culprit to get a bit runny, or the tape will start to shrink a little bit. So for the sake of it, just go to your local B&Q, or you know, they have lots of specials on, or even a pound shop. You can get four rolls in a pound shop of electrical tape. It's actually called PVC tape, but if you ask anybody in the shop for electrical tape, they know what you mean. Now, when you do cut it, now what I advise is you try and get it as straight as possible. Try to only cover the pins, the pin 20, and not over clipping the others. The way I did it is I actually cut about 5 strips to begin with. And I actually inserted the card, and then took out the card, and had a look if the tape was still intact, and if the tape still intact, then it's pretty much good to go. However, you might just have to the tape can come off as you pull it out, so you don't know if the pin if the tape's moving whilst you're inserting it. So the best thing to do is just put it in position, press down hard on it to try and get it to stick well. Electronical tape isn't the best glue they use, however it will ensure that you don't the tape doesn't melt or anything like that. So cover pin 20, try not to cover pin 18 and 22 next to it at all, and that's it really, and I hope it works for you, and I hope you've found this helpful. I'll see you soon. Bye bye.